Hello students, in this video let us be discuss regarding the replication of DNA, that is DNA replication. See, as you know in previous video, so the definition of replication of DNA. Replication is one of the important process which is done by a very specific biomolecules, that is nucleic acids, especially the DNA. DNA can undergo replication, but the proteins or any other biomolecules like carbohydrates, so many are there, they are not conducting this process, that is replication. So also we discuss replication is nothing but it's a self duplication or it's copying its own, right? So it's a process of formation of two daughter DNA molecules from its parent is known as replication. So it's a autocatalytic process, because so the replication is depends on the DNA only. Many enzymes are required there, right? So many enzymes are required and substrates are required, so in this process. So let us, in this video we will talk about the many enzymes which are involved in the replication process. There are enzymes, there is a list of enzymes which are involved, which are necessary for this completion of the process. As you know, enzymes are nothing but proteinaceous substance which are involved in the reactions, right? So this is what biochemical reaction, we can say biochemical metabolic activities, right? These are the metabolic activities we can consider, which is takes place in the cell. As you know, the first during cell division, so replication is takes place, especially the interphase, that is synthetic phase, interphase of that is a synthetic phase, what we call synthetic phase of the cell cycle. Cell cycle shows that interphase. In that interphase there is a G1 S phase and G2 phase. In the S phase, that is called synthetic phase, where the replication process is conducted. So the replication, this phase may be about, it may up to 30 minutes to some about even hours together. This may takes place in cell to cell, there is a difference, right? So here there are many enzymes which are used or involved in this phenomenon, that is called replication, what we call. There are many enzymes. First one, so initiator proteins, what we call initiator proteins, which are involved in the this process, that is replication. So initiator protein, and next one helicase, so tofo isomerase. Next, single strand stabilizing enzyme or protein, so ligase, that is also called DNA ligase. Next, RNA primase, DNA polymerase, and DNA polymerase 3. So even we call it as first, DNA polymerase 3 has 3 subunits, let us we discuss it later. And next one, phosphorylase and nuclease. There are 10 number of enzymes what I have listed here. So these are necessary for the completion of this replication. So as you know, replication means it is doubling its own, right? So now with the help of these enzymes, it is conducting this process. So that is first one, initiator proteins. Initiator proteins, as its name, initiator, see, the it helps in the, that is binds to origin and separates the strands of DNA, separates the strands which are binds to the origin of replication, what we called. So later on we will understand that origin of replication, where it begins. So that is what the origin place, right? Binds, this protein binds to origin and separates the strands of DNA to initiate the replication, which is the initiator, right? So which initiates this process of replication. So hence we referred it as an initiator proteins, right? Next one, the helicase, what you call helicase, right? So helicase is one of the enzyme which is involved in, even we also call it as unwindase, because which opens the twisted DNA. So usually DNA is in twisted form, as you know. So the what you call twisted ladder like structures, already we know this one. So this is not the straight form, so it is actually in the form of so twisted like this, right? So it is twisted in this form. So these are get opened in this form first, okay? So this is called unwinding or open of this twist form into this form, okay? So this is what we call unwinding. So So that is the helicase is performing this function. So that is opening of the DNA double helix by breaking hydrogen bonds. So actually you know that, so there are hydrogen bonds, right? So these are the hydrogen bonds, so which are there, no, here. So this unwinding as well as breaking into two separate strands. So these are the hydrogen bonds, two nitrogen base pairs. In between nitrogen base pairs, there is a presence of hydrogen bonds as you studied in the structure of DNA, right? So these are get separated, right? So these are, when they get separated, these two strands are get separates complete, okay? So there may be a Y like structure is formed, that will be studied in the mechanism, right? So helicase function is unwinding or open the helix, right, by breaking hydrogen bonds. These are the hydrogen bonds, as you know, present between nitrogen bases, right, nucleotides, in complementary nucleotides. So there is a hydrogen bonds of either double bond or triple bond, so which are get separated, and two strands are get separates, right? So that is the helicase, right? So this is what one of the important enzyme. Next one, topoisomerase means, so it's also called DNA gyrase. It's also referred as DNA gyrase. DNA gyrase. It's a class of. It's one of the enzyme which belongs to the topoisomerase group, right? Class of enzymes, that is. So either you can write DNA gyrase or topoisomerase. See, this topoisomerase can release the tension which is exerted during the uncoiling, right? So during this unwinding process, the tension is arised in these strands, right? These strands are simply not become this straight line, so they are get separated like this, right? So this topology of the DNA, we can say topology means, so what we call, this is not the linear, right? So there is a tension or a kind of force is exerted there, so which is released, right? So that is the release the tension of separated helical strands. These separated strands, again these strands are get separated and they are release their tension in presence of topoisomerase, right? So how it happens? So first it cuts the some bonds between the strand, right? So that cuts and it may rotates and become linear, then reseals, right? So this mechanism, so this the strands, the separated strands become straight, right? So that is what the release the tension from that separated strands. So that is what topoisomerase, right? Next one, single strand stabilizing enzyme or protein. So this separated strands are get stabilized in presence of this enzyme that is called single strand stabilizing enzyme or a protein, right? So this strand is get stabilized in presence of this stabilizing protein or a stabilizing enzyme, right? So that is separated strands get stabilized in presence of this one, that is single strand stabilizing enzyme, right? So next one is, that is ligase, what you call DNA ligase, also called DNA ligase, so which helps in joining of DNA fragments. See, joining of DNA fragments, so you will understand this process after studying that structure of replication fork. So there is one is continuously forming new strands. There are two complementary strands are formed, no? New strands are formed, so which are like fragments, right? So that fragments are joined with the help of this ligase. It's like a molecular gum, we can call. We can say that molecular gum, so which joins the two molecules, right? So that is called ligase. And this joining of DNA fragments, this DNA fragments, so in leading strand and lagging strands we call, no? So in lagging strands, after that you will understand that what is lagging and what is leading strand. So usually what happens here, the fork is formed, no? Here one is become continuous, another one, so these are the what we call parental strands, or also called templates, right? So next, here what happens, the two strands are formed, no? So this is become segments. So smaller units like formation is there, it's continuous. So this strands are get joined, that means this is become continuous. After that in mechanism I will explain it, okay? So we'll understand later. Remember, this ligase helps in joining of DNA fragments, such Okazaki fragments we call, no? So those are joined by the help of this ligase. And one more, DNA primase is very important one. So primer synthesis is takes place in presence of this DNA primase. Primase means for the formation of new strands, for the formation of new strands of DNA. So new strands, that is also called complementary strands. So there is a, at the beginning, so there is a requirement of a small segment of RNA. So that RNA, some about 6 to 8 or some number of nucleotides, RNA nucleotides joined to form a RNA segment. So that RNA segment is nothing but the primer, that is the RNA, small RNA segment, what we call a small RNA segment. RNA segment or fragment is called primer. What you call primer? So this, for the synthesis of this small segment of RNA, there is a requirement of a DNA primase, because it is a DNA dependent, right? So primase is required to synthesize the primer. Primer is nothing but, so that's a RNA segment which is required for the joining the next nucleotides, because which provides the OH functional group. So here OH functional group is formed. So this OH group is become functional group, and to that next substrates like nucleotides are joined, right? So which are complementary to this strand. So this is not completely formed. First the actually this primer is formed, right? So in the same way here also primers are formed in these areas, and which allowed to continue the next, that formation of strand, new strand, right? So that is DNA primase. Next one, the DNA polymerase, which removal of primers, and replace that primers with the help of DNA nucleotides. Usually then in this RNA segment, means RNA nucleotides are there, so which is not the DNA, right? So this is removed, okay, this is removed, and that place is replaced by DNA nucleotides. So for that DNA polymerase, so even sometimes DNA polymerase first, we can say DNA polymerase first. So it's class of enzymes related to polymerase, and which helps in the polymerization. Polymerization means the monomers are joined to form a long chain. So here nucleotides are joined to form a polynucleotide strand. So in this way, what happens here, the new strand is completely formed. Before the starting, at initially, so there is a primer was present at the starting point, right? So this was replaced here in this strand, one side. So in another strand, so what happens, so there are many primers are formed here. These primers are replaced, by the this what you call polymerase first, okay? That is what removal of primers, that RNA segments are removed, and then that are replaced by DNA segments or DNA nucleotides. So few nucleotides to join to form a DNA segment, right? So the here RNA nucleotides are replaced by DNA nucleotides also, you can say, right? So that is the DNA polymerase function. Next one, DNA polymerase 3, it is another group of enzymes what we called here. So this helps to elongates the new nucleotide strand by providing OH, and here there are three subunits we observed in DNA polymerase 3. There are three subunits are there, alpha subunit and epsilon subunit, and next one is beta 2 subunit. beta 2 subunits. They are performing some functions here. So especially these are involved in the elongation of new nucleotide strands. The new nucleotides are get elongated, so which are formed completely in presence of this these subunits, that is DNA polymerase subunits, DNA polymerase 3 we can say. So the alpha subunit helps in catalyzing the rate of reactions may increases, so that is catalyzing function or catalytic in function. Next epsilon subunit, which helps in the proofreading. So it's one of the important mechanism. Proofreading means which makes it correction if any misleading if happens here. So any miss what you called nucleotide, so that is not allowed to mismatch, or the that should be complementary to the template strand. Okay, so which will be maintained with the help of this epsilon subunit, that is called proofreading, right? So next the beta 2 subunit helps in sliding and clamping, so which are joining, right? So next one, the phosphorylase is one of the enzyme which is helps in addition of phosphate to activation of nucleotides. Usually nucleotides are the substrates which are present in the cell, right? During the formation of this new strand, that nucleotides are become activated. So that is what the AMP, what you called adenosine monophosphate, AMP, for example, I will take adenosine monophosphate is become adenosine triphosphate, ATP or ADP, like, right? ADP, if it is ADP, so it's become ATP, right? ADP, adenosine diphosphate, so which is forms into ATP, which is active form of this yes, monophosphates, or so AMP, so plus phosphate, here also plus phosphate. Right? So in this way, the phosphorylation, so during that addition of phosphate, so which makes it active, that is nucleotides are become active, right? Next one, the last one, that is nuclease. So nuclease is also helps in proofreading, as I explained here. So this epsilon subunit is also helps in the proofreading, and this nuclease is also helps in the proofreading. Proofreading means which is not allowed to mismatch, or what we called the particular nucleotide must so continue that, right? The either in both strands, which should be complementary, we can say, okay, as per the sequence which are present in the already in the parent strand. So that should be referred as template, and a newly formed one is called complementary. So the complementary nucleotides must come and join there, right? That is what you called corrected by this proofreader, what you called this epsilon subunit of DNA polymerase and nuclease, both are functioning same, right? So these are the enzymes which are required for the this what you called replication process, right? So this replication takes place in the cell of all living beings, as you know, so during the synthetic phase of the cell cycle, right? So and the mechanism of replication we will discuss in the next video. Thank you, students.